Next, we will see about the hypervitaminosis. This is condition occur because of the excessive consumption of the vitamins. If you are consuming vitamin in a increased amount beyond the normal limit, the condition occurs that is a hypervitaminosis. Now we will discuss what is a hypervitaminosis. So, the consumption of an excessive amount of any one vitamin can cause serious health problem. So, as we have talked, there are two types of vitamins are there: fat soluble and water soluble. Fat soluble vitamins are vitamin A, D, E and K, whereas water soluble vitamins are vitamin B and C. So, any of this vitamin, if you are consuming in a higher amount, if you are taking in an excessive amount, that may cause serious health problem, and that condition is known as a hypervitaminosis. This condition is known as a hypervitaminosis or vitamin toxicity. So, these both terms are same, that is occur because of the excessive consumption of the vitamin may cause hypervitaminosis or the vitamin toxicity. Owing to their ability to accumulate in the body, fat soluble vitamins have a higher potentiality for toxicity than the water soluble vitamins. Okay, fat soluble vitamins, that means vitamin A, D, E, K, may cause major health issue if they are taken in a larger amount, okay, compared to the water soluble vitamins, because water soluble vitamins sometimes may excreted by our body via urination, via sweating, perspiration, okay, so they are removed by the body, but the fat soluble vitamins which are stored in the fat, that are not removed by the body, and if there is excessive consumption of the fat soluble vitamin like vitamin A, D, E, K, that may cause the major impact to the health. Some medications can increase the risk of vitamin toxicity. Nowadays, vitamin tablets are available. Multivitamin tablets are available. So, if any person is taking that tablets in an excessive amount, that may cause the vitamin toxicity, that means hypervitaminosis. Now, first is the vitamin A toxicity. If you are consuming vitamin A in an excessive amount, then what happens? If the person is having hypervitaminosis of vitamin A, they may having lack of appetite, the person is not feeling for food, they may have dry and itchy skin, there will be the dryness of the skin, and because of the dryness, the person is feeling itching. There may be loss of hair from the scalp, from the eyelids, from the eyebrows. Then the serious effects are liver damage. Okay, the vitamin A toxicity is leading to the damage to the liver. Fetal defect, okay, occur in the pregnancy. So during the pregnancy time, if someone, the mother has taken vitamin A in excessive amount, that may lead to the effect or defect in the fetal. And there are also chances of the miscarriage because of the vitamin A toxicity. Next is a vitamin D toxicity. So, because of the toxicity or because of the excessive consumption of vitamin D, person may suffering from high blood pressure. So, the normal blood pressure is 120 by 80 mm of Hg. But if the person is consuming vitamin D in an excessive amount, that may cause increase in the blood pressure. The person may also suffering from the excessive thirst. The person is feeling so much thirsty. Because of the increased intake of the water, the person may also feel excessive urination. There will be the high blood cholesterol, calcium level because of the vitamin D toxicity. Because vitamin D is responsible for the absorption of the calcium. So, if in your body vitamin D is higher, the absorption of calcium is also higher. So, that may lead to the high level of calcium in the bloodstream. Moreover, there may be the chances of calcium. Okay. So, calcium stone. Because body has absorbed so much calcium that may transfer to the stone formation. So the chances of getting kidney stone, especially the calcium stone, is increased. And because of the kidney stone, if you are not treating it, it may lead to the kidney failure. Next one is the vitamin E toxicity. So vitamin E toxicity occur that may lead to the muscular weakness, fatigue, and the nausea. Next one is the vitamin K toxicity. So if there is an increased vitamin K, it may lead to the anemia. Okay, anemia, that means decrease RBCs or HB, and jaundice, that means yellowish discoloration of skin. Next is the vitamin C toxicity, that means diarrhea. If you are consuming vitamin C in an excessive amount, that may lead to the diarrhea. Thiamine deficiency, that is a vitamin B1, that is a no toxic. There is a no toxic effect of thiamine toxicity. Riboflavin is also non-toxic. There is no any allergic reaction occur because of the excessive consumption of the riboflavin. Next one is the niacin toxicity. If you are consuming niacin in a higher amount, it may lead to the liver damage, increased level of uric acid in the body, glucose in the blood more than 3 grams, and increased use of glycogen during the exercise. Then pyridoxine toxicity. Pyridoxine increase in consumption may lead to the nerve damage and lack of muscular control. Other vitamins like folate, that means vitamin B9, B12, B7 and B5. These all vitamins, they are non-toxin vitamins. There is no any toxic effect occur of the vitamin B9, that is a folate, vitamin B12, that is a cyanocobalamin, vitamin B7, that is a biotin, and vitamin B5, that is a pantothenic acid. So there are no any toxic effect of these 4 vitamins.